Leon Panetta has a wealth of experience here in Washington, not only serving as the defense secretary, the CIA director, earlier the White House chief of staff, the budget director, a longtime member of the House of Representatives. So, Mr. Secretary, if anyone can come up with a solution to solve this crisis in Washington, I suspect it's you. How would you fix this immediate crisis, the government shutdown?
Well, Wolf, you know, I think the first thing is that everybody's going to have to put politics aside for the moment and take the steps that are necessary to deal with this crisis. I think it's a two-step process. Number one, the Speaker has to allow the House to vote on both a clean CR as well as a lift in the debt ceiling and extend both of those through mid-December. And at the same time, I think they ought to convene a conference on the budget so that they can negotiate, both sides can negotiate on the issues that are important for them to focus on entitlement programs, on discretionary spending, on tax reform, with the hope that they can come up with some kind of deal that could deal with both the deficit and the sequester problem. That is a way to try to put government back in the place it should be.
Well, that sounds like a pretty reasonable idea to get through this immediate crisis on the government shutdown, raising the debt ceiling. Why aren't they, both sides, accepting your advice? I assume they appreciate the possibility of a two-tier program like that as well.
Well, I would hope that they would. I mean, I think right now, you know, both sides are kind of caught up in trying to stare the other side down. And I understand the politics of that, but you know, this shutdown is doing terrible damage to this country. Members of Congress are sworn to protect and defend the Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic. This shutdown is not only hurting innocent people in this country, it's not only hurting our economy, it's hurting our national defense. And they have an obligation and a responsibility to get the government going again.
If the president asks you for some advice, what should he, as the commander-in-chief, as the president of the United States, be doing right now to end this shutdown and raise the debt ceiling?
I think the president needs to have a quiet conversation with the speaker. You know, not with a bunch of people around, not with cameras around, not with the rest of the leadership around, but just a quiet conversation to try, first of all, to restore some degree of trust so they can talk about how they do deal with this. But I think the path forward is pretty clear. I mean, the Speaker is going to have to allow the House to do what he has always talked about, which is regular orders, allow the House to be able to express itself through a majority vote, get a clean CR passed, get a lifting of the debt ceiling so we don't face that crisis, move it all to December, and then begin negotiating. That's what everybody's talking about. It's what the Speaker's talking about. It's what the President's talking about. And you can negotiate on the key issues involving entitlements and discretionary spending and tax reform and try to come up with some kind of deal that would help restore confidence in this country that we can govern.
If the president were to call John Boehner and the speaker, just the two of them, without Harry Reid, Nancy Pelosi, Mitch McConnell, or anyone else, just the two of them, let's say they came up with an agreement and they worked it out. Here's the question. Could Boehner deliver his own Republican caucus?
Well, I understand that, you know, that's the concern. Obviously, it's the concern that the speaker has as to whether or not, you know, his Republicans would back him up. But this is a point at which the interests of the country are a hell of a lot more important than the parties. This country is hurting right now. And I think that what you need to do is to allow the House, both Democrats and Republicans, to vote on this issue. I suspect you could get a majority of Republicans, along with a majority of Democrats, supporting a clean CR, supporting a lifting of the debt ceiling in order to allow room to negotiate. That's what you've got to do here. And I think responsible people on both sides ought to have a chance to be able to express themselves. You know, you can't let the extremes control the party. We've had extremes. When I was in the Congress, we had extremes. There were extremes always on both sides of the aisle. But you don't allow them to govern the country. You've got to govern by people that will take a responsible approach to what needs to be done in order to protect this country.
Well, I'm really worried about those 400,000 civilian Defense Department employees who have now been furloughed. The longer this goes on, the more the national security risks grow. But you're a former defense secretary, former director of the CIA. Is this a real source of concern?
Absolutely. I am very concerned about the message that we are sending our adversaries in the world. We're sending them a message of weakness, that the United States cannot govern itself. And that's the worst kind of message to send to a very dangerous world. At the same time, over 70% of our intelligence personnel are on furlough. So we're not gathering the kind of intelligence we absolutely have to gather to protect this country. We have cut 50% of the civilian workforce at DOD, who are also on furlough, so that our military, even though they're there, are not getting the support they need. So all of this is impacting on our readiness and our ability to be able to defend ourselves. This is a tragic moment for the United States. In a very dangerous world, we are taking steps to weaken the United States in terms of our national security. Members need to understand that that is a price we cannot afford to pay in the kind of world we live in.
And as serious as these national security concerns are, from what I'm hearing from all sorts of economists and Treasury Department officials, if the debt ceiling is not raised, it won't only impact the U.S. economy, the economy could go into a deep recession, it would impact the global economy. But speak as a former budget director, head of the Office of Management and Budget.
Well, you know, the debt limit is something that is critical to our ability to maintain our economy. It's that simple. We you know, if the debt limit is not lifted and we don't maintain the full faith and credit of the United States, then it's going to badly damage our economy, and it's going to, again, hurt not only our economy, but people. That's what bothers me most of all about all of this, Wolf, is that, you know, when you're elected to represent people, you're elected to protect them, not to hurt them, not to hurt our economy, not to hurt our national defense. You swear to not only defend this country, but to fulfill your duties as a representative of the people. When people are being deliberately hurt, when our economy is being deliberately hurt, these members, in many ways, are violating their very oath of office.